That merger is going to have a long-term effect on New Bern's ability to buy power. It's going to have a long-term effect on a lot of cities' ability to buy power. We have to figure out how it's going to affect New Bern. This, everybody's worried about their electric bills. I get calls, each one of us gets calls from people saying, hey look, I have a $900 electric bill. We ran on the platform of helping to lower, or finding ways to lower electric bills. This is a historic opportunity for not only New Bern, but for each one of the electric cities out there to have a direct impact. This is the best chance we've had in like 30 years since this thing was, since the inception of this, to effectuate a change, to effectuate lower rates. We have, and we're going to have a frank discussion about it because it's that serious. We've never been presented with such an opportunity before. Tomorrow, I'm going to talk to the Electric Cities Commission up in Wilson, and I'm going to read a statement that from the city. This is a draft that has come from the city manager and from John Wren, our director of our electric department. And this is the way it goes. I decided to address this board and the Electric City staff in order to convey the importance that this development will have to one of our most critical challenges, power supply, costs, and their effect on the retail rates within the 32 cities that are members of the North Carolina Eastern Municipal Power Agency. The merger of these two large investor-owned utilities presents both a threat to and an opportunity for the power agency. The merger removes the competitive nature of having two large generation transmission entities in close proximity, because it would merge Duke and Progress, from which the power agency can receive the required supplemented power needed by its members. Just so the people at home know, the power agency is where we get our power now. And we'll discuss that more later. The removal of this competition adds an obstacle to gaining advantageous pricing for our supplemental power supply contract and may greatly affect those costs in the future contract negotiations. This merger also creates the situation of the power agency being an even smaller part in the ownership of generation assets with the new Duke Power, lessening the influence that the power agency can have on operation costs associated with these plants. So it actually may increase the cost of our electricity, and that's not what we want. As the ownership of these plants and the costs associated with that ownership accounts for nearly 40% of the annual budget of the Eastern Power Agency, this is a great concern to not only New Bern, but to all 32 members of the electric cities here in the East. The merger promises to worsen a long-term trend in which Duke and Progress have substantially improved their competitive positions over time, while the agency member cities, totally dependent on Progress Energy operation of the jointly owned plants, has seen its retail rates rise 30% above those of Progress Energy. That means New Bern and the electric cities are paying 30% more right now than Progress Energy. The merger presents a unique opportunity to draw regulators' attention to the anti-competitive impacts of the existing situation and of the proposed merger, and to seek remedies for those adverse impacts. During the merger approval process by the North Carolina Utilities Commission and the Federal Energy Regulatory Commission, they also have to go through the Department of Justice and the Nuclear Regulatory Commission, this agency will have an opportunity to strategically oppose aspects of the merger to the power agency's benefit before a neutral party, as opposed to seeking redress through bilateral negotiation, which means that we can join together now as not only a city, but as 32 cities in the power, in the electric cities, and through our political process, put pressure on Duke and Progress and the regulatory agencies to effectuate the outcome in our benefit for a change. And that's what we're looking at. That's what we're going to discuss tonight. how best to do it. It is this strategic input to these regulatory bodies that will enhance our city's ability to protect their interests and advance our agenda for a change. I cannot stress enough the importance of the plan for addressing these bodies and the process of the merger to the power agency. It's my recommendation, and we're going to discuss this more, that a team be formed to draft the necessary plan to take full advantage of this opportunity. We're going to go tomorrow to find out what the team is going to look like. If it looks like Electric Cities is going to help us in this process, we will go with Electric Cities. If it looks like we're not going to get help from the people who are supposed to represent us, the city of New Bern will form a coalition and of the other 32 Electric Cities, and we're going to use those 500,000 people to effectuate change for us, not for the existing status quo. As a show of solidarity of these efforts, I request that each member city pass a resolution in support of protecting our customers' interests and needs during this merger process. I've drafted, meaning the city of New Bern has drafted, a resolution expressing this, and ask that each city consider adopting this resolution on the same date in the near future. What that means is we're going to put together a resolution from this city, speaking as one body. We're going to take it to each one of those 32 electric cities, and I'm going to talk to each one of those mayors tomorrow. And what we're going to do is I'm going to say, as 32 cities together, 500,000 people together, we have a voice. Please join us. Please join us. And I'm going to talk to him, and I'd love to have Bobby Astor there because he could talk to an Eskimo to buy him snow. But we're going to go up there and we're going to try. He could actually. We're going to go up there and we're going to try and get consensus and then move forward as a body of 500,000 people. That's what the plan is. And that's what we're doing. Tonight you're going to hear a presentation from John.
Where do we get our power? Who is Electric Cities? What is Nick Hemba? Why did we join the power agency? Where does the money from electric bills go? Can we get out of the contracts with the power agency? What is the city doing to help people lower their bills? And the last one is the latest news on electric consumption and electric rates. Why are we in the electric business? Well, the city of New Bern got into being an electric utility, as many other cities did, basically to provide street lighting for safety for its persons that live within the city. So back in 1901, we actually started putting together a system. We hired engineers to design it, and the first things that we put in were 62 arc lights that were in downtown New Bern. After 1902, we left those lights running continuously. So that was our start. We started out just providing street lighting. Why are we in the electric business? Well, today, we went from providing street lighting to now providing power to about 21,200 customers. Public power cities as ours benefit from operating their own utilities in numerous ways. We have higher system reliability than investor-owned utilities because we're local. We focus on a smaller service area. We have efficient storm response for the very same reason. We have local customer service. That means that when you want to talk about your utility rates or your bill, you flow an outflow of power for the 32 cities in the east and the 19 cities in the west. The North Carolina Eastern Municipal Power Agency, which we are part of.
I got this when you were doing your presentation. Can we get out of the power agency? That's the question that I've been asked a million times. Each one of you has been asked that a million times. And the answer has always been no. Oh, we can't get out of the power agency. We have to understand the historic nature of this Duke in progress. This changes a lot of things. I'm sitting here looking at the News and Observer online. This is what Duke in progress have said. It says that the merger is going to be a boon to shareholders and customers alike, saying the bigger company will be better positioned to build nuclear plants, boost stock value, and manage electric costs. The benefit to shareholders will come over time as the trims operating costs and is allowed to borrow capital at lower interest rates. You know what it doesn't say? It doesn't say anything about New Bern. It doesn't say anything about electric cities. It says shareholders are going to get a better deal. It says shareholders' electric rates are going to come down. It says the combined company will be better for them. So when the question that we have, and nobody knows the answer to this, but the question now has become, when you ask, and I think this is what we all have to understand and do this in a respectable, level-headed way, the answer to your question, can we get out of the power agency, has gone from a no, black and white, carved in stone, no, to maybe, if we play our cards right. And that's what I think that this, that's what I think that this board needs to understand right now. I'm not saying it's a maybe. Does that mean a 1% chance? Does that mean a 51% chance? But any chance to lower the electric bills for our citizens is worth going after, and it's worth having discussions about. And I know each one of these board members is chomping at the bit right now to give their opinion on it. And you know, it ranges the scope from I'm not going to speak for the aldermen, but there's a diverse range of opinions on how to go about doing it. What we do know is that we have to do something. Duke and Progress have touted the merger as a boon to shareholders and customers. They're all benefiting. Guess what? It's time for New Bern and the 32 electric cities to see if this is true or not. But in addressing any problem, and especially a problem of this magnitude, you can work with them and within the existing structure, or you can say, you know what, we're going to get better results by forming a coalition and going in with our coalition. The history, and Dana, correct me if I'm wrong, but let's just go into a little bit of the history and some of the obstacles that we may have in going within the system. Electric Cities is really made up of, I think, two or three different entities in there. One of them is a trade association. This trade association was initially started in the late 60s in order to allow all
the franchise. They're the ones who are really suffering because of these rates, and they have no voice. We are their voice. So we are the ones that must step up to the plate. We must convince the other 32 cities, which are all Eastern North Carolina cities, that their citizens are disenfranchised as well, and that, you know, a half a million citizens speaking in one voice through their elected officials say so much more than you speaking to elected citizens. Just the way it is. So I want you to go there. I want you to speak loudly and clearly, but I want it to be very well thought out, very well put together, and very clear so that the rest of them will have to sign on. Because if they don't, when they read the paper the next day, their citizens are going to be saying to them, what's wrong with you? Why haven't you signed on for this? Why haven't you backed this up? Because we've got to lower our utility rates.
And to reinforce what Sabrina was saying, and to go back to the history of Electric Cities was the voice of the people. Whether it is still the voice of the people, or whether it's become an entrenched bureaucracy incapable of representing the people, that's something that Electric Cities is going to have to show us, and they're going to have to justify their existence right now, just like everybody else. And I think I hear down here a point of view saying, look, that's an entrenched bureaucracy that is not going to represent the people. And what I hear down here is that we need a coalition. We can't go it alone.
This whole deal, the Progress Energy Duke Power, we are nothing more than a big cottage plant. Nobody's paid the Electric Cities any attention. Obviously, I have not heard anything and read anything about anybody lobbying on our part to be a part of this merger. If you get right down to it, I think the Duke customers, because they're number of customers per mile versus Progress Energy, I think Duke customers will have some concerns whether or not their rates are going to go up a little bit in the merger and that farmers' rates are a little higher. And so there's that to begin with. So if a good customer is worried about their rate because they might be going into a partnership merger with a company that's got slightly higher rate, then what do you think the electric cities collective, 32 cities, should be saying and thinking? I don't see how the Eastern Power Agency could have been left out of this, and it would be left out of it, unless somebody steps in plate and demands our consideration.
Merger.
I don't see any statement from electric cities.
And that's because number one, electric cities is what it ought to be. It's a trade organization. Now, in North Carolina, there's this stuff called real estate. And there's a thing called the North Carolina Association of Realtors. But nobody in the General Assembly allows that trade association to regulate real estate. It is regulated through occupation boards, from the home inspection board to the appraisal board to the real estate commission. So how in the world a trade organization by the name of electricity's ever got into the position to manage a power agency development? But I don't see how, number one, I mean, outside of all this, that needs to be done away with by itself. And if Duke and Progress are doing all this as a part of downsizing and a larger collective economies of scale, I've never heard anything you can do to let real quick. Out of all this economic calamity going on, I would doubt power agency has done any downsizing.
But I mean, like Alderman Outlaw said, you know, the country is tight as hell. You know, we as a board is stepping up to the plate, and hopefully tomorrow that, you know, John, yourself, and Mr. Booker will go there expeditiously and stand up and fight for what we have to have here. Because we have citizens here in Bern that a month, that they actually have to go make a sacrifice on the food, medication, bills, just to stay warm. And I mean, they're constantly telling me that this is what's happening, and we're working expeditiously as hard as we can to try to find out what we can do to help them. But if we have to stand up as a city alone and try to get this thing to work, we're going to have to just do that. And I feel very strong that the other cities will actually take the lead, because they do not want to be left behind in this situation. So I'm counting on you tomorrow to go there and really, like Alderman Davis said, think this thing out, put it in the right perspective, where we can go there and let them know where we're coming from.
And we'll be able to arrange the mayor of just about every other city. So, so who knows what's going on down there, but we'll find out. John, I think it's very clear what we have to do tomorrow. Anybody else? Input?
I just never have heard what you're off, what you want.
Tell us what you want.
I'm not hearing.
I'm just a mayor. I mean, what I'm hearing is a consensus. If everything comes here, we're gonna get a consensus. The consensus is that we want to be bought out of the. We want to be bought, and we.
Did you say that? Is that it, mayor?
That's what we're trying to determine right now. We're coming to a consensus of what we're saying. How to go about getting what we want is what we're actually discussing. I believe we know what we want. How we go about getting what we want is what we're discussing. I want the exact same thing that you want. It's the exact same thing what I hear Sabrina wants, the exact same thing I hear Mr. Taylor, and Mr. Kinsey, and Mr. White. We all want the same thing. Now, how do we get it? And that's what we're discussing. There is no doubt we all want the same thing. And you've heard that loud and clear, correct? how we go about getting horse, and that's the rabbits, whatever, and jousted a windmill. Believe me, if we have to go alone, I'll lead the charge. I'm no stranger to that. So, but you know, if that's the way it is, fine. I'll mount that horse. We'll maneuver and mount the horse collectively, and we'll charge it alone. But I'd rather find out who's going to be with us first, so that we don't have to go alone.
We don't need to worry about that right now. The thing that we have to do is deliver.
Correct. And that's what we're going
to do is deliver.
That's correct. Exactly what we're going to do. Maybe. Yes, Mr. Epstein.
Just had a couple observations, and I'm still the new guy, so sometimes I see things clearly, sometimes I may not see things clearly at all. Electric Cities works for us and the other cities. I think it's fair for us to go there and demand what we want to demand. I think what I'm hearing tonight is that a demand is the voice of the mayors representing the cities and the people of those cities needs to be part of the process. Right, and the other thing is that this is a multi-level legal process, right? It's a lawyer's dream. It's multi-levels of legal proceedings that have to occur, and I think one thing that that I would think that we in all cities would want to watch for is Electric Cities has the ability through this legal proceeding to use potentially consultants, legal advisors, and so forth. We need to make sure they pick the right ones. We need to make sure they're objective, not too close to maybe the history of Electric City, so that they can fairly represent us as cities. But you know, what I've asked John to do for us, and I know the mayor knows about this as well, we need to be plugged into the timeline, make sure that we understand when the important milestones are going to be met, and certainly whatever this board wants us to do to try to facilitate anything on behalf of our city or all the other cities we'd be happy to do.
Well said. John, with the road?
No, I think you got it.
Well, I'm still at 9:09. I'm going to make a motion that your speech tomorrow includes the request of the city of Newbern that the assets of the power agency, the Eastern, I only speak to Eastern power agency, I think Western, North Carolina portion is a whole different situation, that the power agency, Eastern power agency, as for the merger to take place, is be bought out by the Duke Progress Energy merger, and all debt of the 32 cities, power cities, power agency cities, be assumed into the merger. And you have to be, again, very careful how you word that, because those lawyers and that the powers that be up there will nail up your A2 cent for saying it if you don't, not careful. I mean, you just have to be real careful and absolutely.
I'm here with Mayor Lee Bettis in Newbern, North Carolina, and Mr. Mayor, I understand tomorrow you're going on a very special trip.
That is true. Tomorrow I'm going to the Electric Cities. One of the things that we are going to ask for in the merger between Duke Power and Progress Energy is that, in no uncertain terms, we would like Duke Power, Progress Energy, to buy out the debt of the Eastern Carolina Municipal Power Authority, buy out all our debt, get us out of the electric business, and let us be Progress or Duke Power Company customers. That's what we want.